Did you get out of something?
I was trying. Sid wouldn't let me do it. No, that's not true. I don't want anybody to think that. Beautiful day out. Looking forward to getting outside because we're going to be on a plane and in some hotels for a while. So be nice to get out. So with that, I'll just open it up.
How do you stop Tyreek Hill?
Oh, man. I don't know. Get him on your team. Can we get him back on our team? That'd be the best way to stop him. Listen, we know he's elite, and he's going to certainly be all fired up for this game. But you know, we have guys. I was looking at it yesterday or the day before, and I was trying to think of who in our secondary has gone against Tyreek. It's only LJ, I believe, because all the young guys have not really felt. And the one thing about Tyreek and some of the other young guys were asking, if you guys remember, he practiced as hard as he played. So when our guys would go against him in practice, you were like getting a game day Tyreek Hill, not like, you know, some guys that go about 80%. So maybe hopefully there's some carryover there and LJ's used to it, but he's the only guy that's really gone against him. So we know what we're dealing with. We know what the speed, we're cautious of it. Everybody's got to know where he is because it feels like they're trying to get him the ball a lot.
Any old Frankfurt Galaxy gear that you
The gear, I had a... You know, the old windbreaker button-down. I used to have one of those. It was purple because we were purple, and I think there was a little gold. Yeah, something sprinkled. They're great uniforms. That was a tremendous experience. I loved it. We ended up going to the World Bowl, which was in Frankfurt that year. The Berlin Fire beat us. You always remember when you get beat, right? But it was a great atmosphere. The people there, the game was exciting. They cheer constantly. Like, you can't tell if you did good or bad because they're always cheering, which is great. They're really into it. It was a great experience. I wish I could find that jacket.
Yeah, we saw, I think Travis has a jersey in his locker right now.
A Galaxy?
Yeah.
Yeah, Travis can come up with things. I don't have the...
Is it the same stadium you guys...
It's funny you're asking that, and I know the name, but I cannot... I'll know when I get there. Because, seriously, I was looking at pictures of it. And now, because they might have changed it. It's 25 years ago, so I won't know unless if it's the same site and maybe they just refurbished it. It looks a little different, but I can't tell right now whether it's the same. And I don't remember the name of it. I have to go back and look it up. I haven't had time to do that this week.
When it comes to the game with the linebackers and the depth right now, how concerning is it, especially with the speed of the Dolphins?
Yeah, it's a great point. Listen, you know, Nick and Willie are speed linebackers. I mean, they cover as much ground as anybody in this league, and we're not sure where Willie's at right now, and Nick we know is not going to play. We're just going to have to rely on the guys we put in there. Now, Drew certainly has been on a run around real fast, and you guys can see that. Jack will step in there if he has to. You know, Leo will step in there, and he made some plays for us last week. So I feel confident in the guys that we'll put out there. We certainly would like to have Nick and Willie, but we'll see what happens with that. And just if we don't have them, we'll use the guys we got and rally around that.
How quick can Darius work into this?
Yeah, well, the one good thing about Darius is he was here. And the other thing we remembered when we first brought Darius here, and if you guys remember, he kind of had like a redshirt year because he had that injury, so he didn't do anything the whole first year. But what we knew right from the beginning, Matt House was here at the time, and we interviewed Darius, who's a very cerebral linebacker. Like, he's really smart. So I think he'll pick up things quickly. And if we got stuck in a situation he had to go, I mean, at least we know he's had parts of the system before, which is good.
You mentioned LeJarius Sneed. He had that run of a number of penalties.
Yeah.
I asked this of Drew. He was pretty guarded, to be frank, about the answer on it. But I know you guys scout the refs and like, hey, this is a crew that calls a lot of this.
I don't look. Well, I mean, before the game, but then I usually don't go back. Well, I stuck to it. I didn't stick to it. You know, it's interesting. When about, for example, if all of a sudden they don't call a lot of holding penalties or DPIs, it would be hard for me to stand up there and say, look, this crew doesn't call them. So we're very careful. We really just try to play the game clean, to be honest with you. I talk with them a lot about, you know, like you get in a 3rd and 18, a 3rd and 20. Let's be smart, right? Why take a 5-yard holding penalty that's an automatic first down? So I talk more in terms of being smart with the things you can and can't get away with.
One of the things a lot of people have said,
the preview of this game is that the way to do something to the Dolphins is to get them off rhythm. It's so much the timing thing, and you look like you might have a group up front that can help do that. How big a key is that going to be for your front four, especially to get back there and kind of get them off their
rhythm? Yeah, huge. It's a rhythm passing game, and he's really good at it. What I think is really challenging, I was just talking to Mitch about it as I was coming in here. It's one thing to be a drop back team and be rhythm, because you know you, as soon as the lineman pass set, you're in a pass rush mode as a D lineman, and then you go from there. This team has a lot of play action rhythm passes, so everybody up front has to at least respect the fact that it could be a run, and then boom, all of a sudden it's a pass play and he's getting the ball out really quick. That's what he's really good at. I think that's probably one of the main reasons for the success and the high percentage completion rate. What would work best for us is if we can try to, listen, we're talking about the pass. They run the ball as good as anybody. And so we got to begin there. And if there was a way, somehow, some way, we could get the game one-dimensional, then we have a chance to do what you're talking about. But up until that point, it's going to be a little bit difficult. We've got to play it honest, stop the run first, hopefully get them in longer, down in distances so we know what they're going to do, and then try to disrupt the...
Coach, did you ever think 15 years ago you and Antonio Pierce would be fellow top coaches in the AFC?
Yeah, listen, I'll tell you what. I've probably said this before, but Antonio is one of my favorite football players. One of the most cerebral, smartest players I coach. We don't beat the Patriots if Antonio's not running the show on defense. And I'm happy. Listen, I'm pulling for him in all but two games. But I would love. Be honest with you. I knew he wanted to coach. We talked about it. I said, well, go out and make sure you want to do it. He spent 5 years in high school in California as a head coach and did a great job. And then I brought him to New York, and he was a quality control. He got his feet wet, and then he went to Arizona State, and now he's there. I knew the minute he came in the NFL that it wouldn't be long. I just felt like he was that kind of guy. So I'm really happy for him.
What do you know about the Dolphins? McDaniel's an interesting guy. Do you know him well?
I really don't. I got a lot of respect for him. I've talked with people that know him, and listen, he's doing a great job there.
Is he doing anything different than other people? I mean, people are always trying to innovate. Is anything revolutionary about this offense, or is it basically just the fact that they got a whole bunch of really...
Well, there's a lot that has to do with that, but I mean, they're intricate in their motions, but I think our guys do, you know, a lot of the same things. And, you know, this league's a beg, borrow, and steal, so we steal things defensively, offenses steal things, so you're seeing it all over the league now. But they give them all the credit in the world, coaches and players. They've put something together really dynamic that's quite a challenge. And, you know, when you can stand in front of our unit like I did this week and said, look, we're going against the number one offensive unit in the NFL. That's a great challenge. Let's go out and see what we can do.
You mentioned the motions, and I know like Kyle Shanahan and Sean McVay have called it cheat motion, getting the guys at full speed at the snap, so then they're running at a different speed. How difficult does that make it then?
The motioning part of it, you know, getting the fact, you know, they're not supposed to turn up before the ball snap. We know that, right? So hopefully they're going that way. They use it really, really effectively. I don't know this, but my guess is once they got there and saw what Tyreek could do, they probably said, "Oh, we could do." You invent some things when you have that kind of skill set. I don't know how it all evolved, but they make it challenging. They make it challenging.
They get to the edge. I mean, they do some stuff with their motion to get blockers moving to help little guys block big guys.
Yeah.
It feels like that.
Not so much. I mean, little guys blocking big guys, is you don't see it too often. I showed a clip this morning. This is the thing about Tyreek. Like, he's not one of those wideouts that you can get not to block. Like, he's gonna battle you. You can't. There's no quitting him. So even though he's a speed wide receiver, if he's lined up over there, there's a chance he might block you. You better be ready for it.
Let's go last two, PJ.
They obviously have Tyreek, but Waddle and Wilson are also some great pieces, too.
Yeah, we're talking a lot about one guy, but they got speed all over the place. We got to pick our spots. We certainly don't want the most dynamic guy to wreck the game, but if you pay too much, you pay too much attention to one guy, they've got plenty of other people that can beat you, and that's what makes them, we keep saying it, but that's what makes them dynamic, the skill set that they all have.
Steve, with the motioning that they have, how much of it do you have to respect versus not let them misdirect you from where they're actually wanting to go?
Yeah, a little bit of it will depend on what we're in. there are some things that we're in where it won't affect us that much, and then there are other calls that we have where we got to be on. We almost have to anticipate that somebody's going to move, or else you're going to be behind in the down. You're going to be behind the step. So we've preached that.